वेरी गुड. सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम पार्ट्स ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस, डिफ्रेक्शन एंड पोलराइजेशन. इट इज बेसिकली द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑल दोज टॉपिक्स इन डिटेल, और व्हाट वी कैन से लाइक द प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग सेशन फॉर दैट वी विल डिस्कस लेटर व्हेन द कंप्लीट रेगुलर क्लासेस विल बी देयर, एंड वी विल डू एक्सटेंसिव न्यूमेरिकल्स एंड अदर थिंग्स व्हाइल द रेगुलर क्लास विल बी देयर. Okay, so today we'll be having the introduction part. As you know that myself, Dr. Pradeep Kumar Sharma from University of Engineering and Management. Here you can contact me on my number and email ID is also given. So whenever you feel any problem regarding any issue in any subject, you can write to me or you can contact me. So the contact details are given. Today we'll be having a discussion on interference and diffraction. So Huygens principles we'll start with, and I hope all of you know what Huygens principle is. So one by one I am just starting giving you some information about that. Like any wave, including the electromagnetic wave also, is able to propagate because the wave affects nearby points. So wave here affects the nearby point there. So what is actually the concept? There is a source inside that wave which actually gives the energy to another nearby neighboring point, and in that sense the wave is the source for more of the waves. And you can understand that wave here creates you can say the waves in all the forward directions, and for a plane wave the generated waves add up to make more plane waves. So if you concentrate on what we are discussing by having a small see over here, there are certain points which can play the role of the source point, source wave, and it can create a wave, right? And whatsoever the wave is created, those point of source now moving ahead and now giving energy to the out you can say the further media, like this. So this will move and the points again will give the energy to create these kind of waves. So a point on a wave is actually behaves like a source and move forward. So actual point is not moving, basically he is transferring the energy. So mathematically this works very fine, there is no issue, we can show theoretically that it is okay, but actually waves do not do like this. They actually have, you can say, movement in all the directions. So that we can understand using this diffraction through a tiny hole. So a very small tiny hole is there, and waves come out in all directions because the whole wave makes new waves. So waves add up to only go forward. But what we have to do if the wave pass through that tiny hole and it is smaller than a wavelength, that the opening, this opening is actually the smaller than the wavelength of the light. So can you see this? When the electromagnetic wave is hitting that particular point, that point actually acts as a source and it creates like this kind of spreading in all the directions. So wave is spread out in all the directions, and the wave equation, you know that it can be written like E is equal to E naught sine kx minus omega t. We will learn what all these factors are, but E naught is the maximum value and sine kx minus omega t actually governs the value at a particular time. So the total value of the wave is governed by this factor kx minus omega t. Here k is the propagation constant and omega is the frequency, right? So we can write it in this form in any direction, and E is nearly, you can say, sin kr minus omega t. That E naught dashed by r is actually the factor which is governing the final amplitude. So that need to be concentrated. So what is interesting is that oscillation depend on distance from slit. So this opening, this small hole, now we are referring as slit. So what is slit? Slit is a small opening in any place which is actually allowing the wave to pass through and to generate new waves. If there are two slits, definitely there will be two source, right? Equally sized, and there will be two waves like this. You kindly see, this is the first source, this is the second source, and whenever it goes in all the directions, crest add crest. You know the crest, the meaning of the crest and the trough. You know the meaning of the crest and trough. So crest to crest, crest to crest make bigger, brighter crest, and crest combined with trough make minimum areas, minimum intensity. So there will be in the end, if we plot this on any, you can say, screen, we will see the alternate light and dark bands. Where light band is there, means brighter band is there, it means intensity is adding, and where the dark bands are there, it means intensity is minimizing. So that way we can write the equation. We'll discuss all these equations in the regular mode, but right now you kindly understand how these waves are working and how the pictures and other things are going on. You kindly concentrate on that. So if interference through slit we see again, so electromagnetic waves, we consider the distance d in between those slits, and the point is actually adding up. R1 and R2 are nearly same, but having a very small distance. If we say the perpendicular distance, that will be d sin theta, and R2 minus R1, that is actually d sin theta, that is the difference. So that difference, if we are taking into account for the intensity, means the total amplitude part, and we know that intensity is the proportionality factor to square of that amplitude. So that intensity is proportional to E square, and that we got the equation in terms of cos square part. I am not going into any part which is, you can say, extensive mathematical, but kindly try to consider that intensity is proportional to this cos square part. And when this cos square part is there, we know K is the propagation constant. Its value is 2 pi by lambda. And the final equation for intensity we can write, I is equal to I max cos square pi d sin theta by lambda. And if you see this pattern, these are where the light, you can say bright color is there. It is, you can say, constructive interference. And where it is dark bands are available, it is destructive interference. So constructive interference means crest to crest is actually there, or trough to trough. But if crest to trough is there, then there will be minimum or dark band. So this way we can see. So the value of the position where the bright band will be, this will be given by sin theta bright is equal to m lambda by d. And where it is dark, m plus half lambda by d. So you can understand where is the, you can say, a brighter band, the constructive interference, and where is the destructive interference. So if there are four slits, you kindly try to understand now, there will be four slits, so there will be two double slits. Four slit means two double slits. In the same manner, R12 and R34. In the same manner, we can add up the superposition principle, we can apply, and we can get the resultant intensity. Mathematical part I am not trying to convey, it will be discussed later one by one, and then you can understand what we are doing actually. But try to see the pattern in pictures. The brighter side, this one, has now been more thick, and in between two more brighter part there are few darker and brighter sides. So you can understand from this graph there are few peaks, and in between two peaks there are smaller peaks with less intensity. So this is the main part when we are trying to get the interference pattern out of, you can say, a combination of slits. And every, you can say, with four slits, there will be every third band is bright. Okay? So that we need to concentrate on. If there are n slits, so n minus 1, after every n minus 1 band, there will be a bright. Like here in this graph, because total number of slits were 4, so after every third band, or sorry, not after every third band, every third band is bright, right? We kindly see this. So if we go on increasing this number of slits like this, so we will have increased pattern for the interference, and for this, you can say the intermediate part as regularly decreasing intensity. We are increasing n is equal to 8, 16, 32. So you can see the peaks accordingly. It is going on higher and higher. And in the number, you can say in between two peaks, there are number of smaller peaks. The device, which is like having this kind of a structure, where a lot of slits are available, is known as diffraction grating. And this diffraction grating is just transparent with closed space regular lines, and you can use in the laboratory also it is there, and I will show you on computer next time that what is on the laboratory class, that what the diffraction grating looks like. But the condition for the bright side is n lambda by d, and diffraction grating gives you more accurate way of measuring wavelength than a prism, and it is commonly used by all scientists and you can say researchers in their labs. So it's a very good instrument to see the diffraction patterns, and as well as how to calculate the wavelengths and how to find the accurately, you can say, accurate diffraction patterns on the screen. So resolution of diffraction grating, if we say, then there is this part, for there are two wavelengths. If there are lambda is having, suppose some, one is lambda and one is 1.1 lambda. So you can understand that for one angle there is sine theta 1 value, and then again sine theta 2 another value. So there are finite number of slits. Nearby wavelengths may overlap, and we can have this peak, right? So you kindly concentrate on that figure here. On the top of this, there are two peaks. If you are seeing near to this n is equal to 8, there is a peak of red color and there is a peak of blue color, and in between them there is some space. So if this space is very large, you can see those two wavelengths very, you can say, separately. But if the peaks are at the same place, where it is at the center at zero, blue and the red peaks are at the same space, then we cannot say that which wavelength, which color or which wavelength actually is there, because these red and blue you cannot see in practical sense. Okay, you will see the band only. So the number of peaks we can identify using MN if it is very greater than lambda by del lambda. So this quantity is called resolving power. So you kindly note down that this quantity is known as resolving power of that instrument, and resolving power will be higher if it is lambda by d lambda, right? Mn, if it is very large, then we can see the things very easily, very comfortably. So even if n is very large, n is effective, n is how many slits the light beam actually falls on. Now we have tried to understand this concept of diffraction using a single slit. Now see, if our slit is not small compared, and it's very small, you can say a big opening is there for light. So a large number of closely spaced sources will be there. And suppose A is the size of this, and the R average is the distance to the center of that space. So X is the distance of some point from that center. Not X is not from center to the, you can say, the last edge. It is from the center up to any point towards that edge. So distance R for that thing, R average, and this R is nearly same, slightly different from here from point P. So we can have R is equal to R average plus X sin theta. That small difference of X sin theta is there. So E is nearly equal to the same value sin kr minus omega t. So we can put this value, we can solve it. I'm not again trying to say that we are not concentrating on the mathematics. Later you can do it, don't bother about it. It's very simple mathematics though, but I'm right now not bothering about it, that what mathematics we are doing. But when we are having this, this is the equation for the intensity calculation. As you have seen here, the last part, this green portion, sine half k a sine theta divided by half k sine theta, it is the actual governing part for the intensity. I is equal to I max sine half k a sine theta by half k sine theta whole square. So this is the intensity and this is the pattern. So if you see the difference now with the interference part, in interference every fringe, every band was equal spaced, but in diffraction central band is very large and the nearby bands are decreasing with the intensity due to this effect. And you can see in the graph also that the central peak is very strong and after that the small peaks are available. So this is the dark sine theta dark condition, and very similar to equation for multi-slit diffraction, but A is the size and this equation is called dark, not bright, and M is equal to 0 is missing. Okay, so again I am just having for screen and small angles. Sine theta bright and sine theta dark, you all know that what it is, we have done. And if on the screen it's been placed and the distance between the center line to the point where that any dark or any bright slit band is available, and the distance from the slit pattern to the screen is capital L, then you can understand this x by L is 10 theta. I hope you can make out that the angle in between. And for small angles, this is actually equal to 10 theta is equal to sine theta, and x bright, now we can write nearly equal to m L lambda by d, and x dark is nearly the same m L lambda by a. So again this interference together, if we say finite size slits, result is the sum of each slit, amplitude is nearly same in the condition what we have done, and this is the pattern. So this is the resultant pattern. If you see the graph at zero, this is the highest peak, and afterwards the peaks are decreasing with amplitude, right? So this is the diffraction and interference, both the parts are available. So interference and diffraction part both when two slips are available, and resulting pattern has two kind of variation, which is fast fluctuations from separation D as well as slow fluctuations from slip size A. So capital, you see this small d and this small a plays a very vital role of having, you can say, equally spaced bands on the spring. And the diffraction limit we can calculate by using the same concept when sine theta is nearly equal to lambda by a, and this theta minimum is lambda by a. Okay, so if we put light through rectangular hole, means we can experiment with rectangular or circular, so theta minimum is 1.22 lambda by d, right? And we can use this formula, theta minimum is lambda by d. Now I'm skipping this problem, but it's very simple to do. But one information is there. Kindly note it down, or you can take a snap of it. A degree is 1/360 of a circle, you all know. An arc minute is 1/60 of a degree. Arc minute is 1/60 of a degree. And one arc second is 1/60 of an arc minute. And telescope requires large apertures. What is aperture? The opening through which the light can come to see small angles, right? So this was my discussion. We will continue later here, interference and diffraction part. And I hope all of you have got the idea what I have discussed. Now a small quiz is available for you. You kindly, I hope you can do this. I always give you one quiz so that the level of understanding is available with me, that how you have done. So I am just giving you the link for the quiz. You kindly click on this and you can continue with the questions. There are 5 questions. Have you got this?
Yes, sir.
You kindly click on it and start the numericals. Not numerical, there are 5 questions, simple questions. Anhit, have you got the quiz? Shilajit, Vishal, Enamol.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm just opening that.
Quiz. Yes, sir.
Okay. Kindly do this. It's very simple. I think today we are not got any numerical, only simple theoretical questions were there. You have 5 minutes time to submit. It's already 11:36, so 1 minute I consider gone. So at 11:40 I will stop. So kindly try to submit after writing your credentials, your email, your name. Anybody has submitted? Others, have you done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you submitted? Last submission, yes, at the end of the question 5. Okay. I have received 2 submissions. Let me share with you the result also.
Everything is wrong.
Everything
is wrong. My answers
is wrong.
Yes, sir. Everything is wrong. Because, yes, sir.
Are you seeing the presentation? Are you sharing the, are you seeing this screen?
Yes, sir.
This is questions and responses are written. Is it available?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 3 I have received. Still 2 students have to submit. Who has left, I think, earlier 2 students or more, 1 student has left. Okay. Who has not submitted, kindly submit.
Sir, having
some
technical problems.
Okay.
I can't see the whole screen. I can't see the whole screen, sir. Having some technical problems. My answers are also wrong.
Okay, okay. But from my side,
see the home screen,
but from my side, it is not not the problem. Are you able to submit? Arhit, are you able to submit?
Yes, sir.
Have you submitted?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. So, kindly see the result.
Yes, sir. I have submitted.
Yeah, the average you see, the 3.6 out of 10. This average need to be increased. In every class, see, I always take this quiz. And this quiz actually gives an idea how much you are applying yourself. So you see, average marks you got 3.6 out of 10. And hello, now I have got a response from 5th student also. Yes, so I am now stopping the responses. And see here, others has got 0. Others, what's the problem? All questions are wrong.
Sir, maybe because this lockdown period, I have been restricted time in extracurricular activities. So,
okay, okay. So you are not having any idea about means you forgot everything.
Not forgot, but not the complete knowledge of situation.
Okay, okay. Arhit, 4 marks are there. Arhit?
Yes, sir.
4 marks are there. What's the problem?
Yes, sir. My answer is same, sir. I have forgot many things. I have to revise up.
Okay. Shiladit Banerjee, Shiladit? You kindly come up. You should speak. You should speak. Your voice is not clear. VPPS VPPS corner.
यस सर, इट्स मी विशाल।
विशाल, ओके 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 ओके। तो विशाल हैज गॉट द मैक्सिमम 8 टुडे एंड देन इनामुल अंसारी 6। आई ऑलवेज रिक्वेस्ट यू टू पार्टिसिपेट इन अ वेरी पॉजिटिव मैनर एंड नाउ सी द आंसर्स एंड द रिस्पॉन्सेज। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन 3 स्टूडेंट्स हैव गिवन करेक्टली आउट ऑफ 5 and the second question only one student given correctly, third question 3 students, fourth question 1 student only and fifth also 1. Now I'm giving you the answers, you kindly see what are the correct answers for every question. See, for the first one, the main principle used in interference is, see here, this is the answer, superposition principle, and here it is the explanation that superposition principle is the basic principle used. I have seen in my presentation also, I have given you one at one point that we will use superposition principle where E is equal to E1 plus E2, right? So that is actually superposition principle, and when the incoming light waves superimpose constructively, intensity increases, and while when they add destructively, it decreases. So that is there. That is the superposition principle. Now the second question is, when two waves of same amplitude add constructively, the intensity becomes 4 times. Okay, intensity is actually the proportional part to amplitude. So I is proportional to A square. So if same amplitude is there, so it will be, yes.
Voice is less audible.
Now it is clear?
Almost, sir. Yes, sir.
Almost, clear. Now say, now clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So intensity is proportional to amplitude square. So that is why the answer should be 4 times, because the same amplitude is there. Now third one is, if instead of monochromatic light, white light is used for interference, what would be the change in the observation? So the question asks you that we are not using the monochromatic light, we are using the white light. And you know that white light is collection of all the color, all the lights in that. White is not a color actually, white is a mixture. So when white light is used, there will be colored fringes. So white light is a collection of many wavelengths. So you can see there will be fringes with every wavelength. So there will be colored fringe, but at the center, again, all wavelengths will have the maximum intensity at the center, as we have seen. So again, there will be a white pattern at the center. But as soon as we move away from the center, there will be colored fringes. Now the fourth part is, interference is observed only when the phase difference between the two waves is zero. So the answer is false. So you can understand when interference pattern, the phase difference between two rays must be constant. It is not necessary that the phase difference between the two ray has to be zero. So it should be constant. So never means it cannot be, we cannot say never, but the phase difference has to be zero. Compulsory it is not required, but that should be constant. Now the last question says, the shape of the pattern depends on what? Right? And the shape of the pattern depends on the shape of the slit. As we have seen already, if we make out the slit smaller or bigger or circular or like that, the shape of the pattern on the screen will change. Right? So I hope the things are clear to you now. Anything you
sir,
want to add? Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are discussing in the group, sir, in our students group, that there are some problems regarding this PPT. Sir, if in math,
it is
having a problem. We are having a problem that the PPTs are moving fast and we are not able to understand the thing.
You kindly speak loudly. Can you please speak loudly?
Yes, sir. We guys are having a discussion that, sir, in maths class and from physics, in physics class, that we are having a problem with PPT. Besides PPT, if we can add, means if the faculty members can add a pen and paper and try to understand the thing, make understand the thing, it will be helpful, sir. Because the PPT, the slides are moving faster and we are not able to capture it.
Okay. See, that's why for that particular reason, definitely it can be sorted out. But for that reason, the videos are available to you to see again and again. What happens, Arvind, and other students also try to understand. In online education, actually, we always try to move slow, very slow, right? But once a slide is moved, so definitely student cannot remember the what has been written in the last slide. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So that is why we have made this is compulsory to record that video and make available for our students on the video YouTube channel. So what you can do, you can download that video or you can see again, because if the internet issues are there, definitely I think many of the students are having internet issues. So what you can do, you can download once and then you can see as many times, because wherever the problem is, you can stop at that time, right? And then you can,
I have a suggestion.
That can be the solution.
Sir, can you share that PDF with us, what you showed to us?
Yes, this presentation is there. This presentation as well as all the videos are available. Others?
No, sir. Only the PDF, sir.
This PPT.
Because that's easy to download.
This PPT, yes, you are asking?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I will share. Definitely, I'll share. Sir, see here, I am.
That will be less data consuming and.
Yes. See, I am here writing my website address, and yes, over my website address, pradeep.sharma. I'm just giving you. I'm just confused. What is the full name? Just a moment. Yes, it is. Yes, it is opening up. Give me one second. Yes. This is going on. What you will do, you have to go to the website and I will upload all the information on my website, right? All the PPTs.
Yes, sir.
This is my website.
Yes, sir.
So all the syllabus, all the PPTs, all the video lectures, all information you will get from there.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you kindly note it down or save it for further reference. I am again right here. Anything else?
Sir, before starting the regular classes, sir, should we go through a few chapters in class 12? Is there any link between the engineering first semester classes and the class 12 classes?
Yes, sir. Actually, for that purpose only, these what we have discussed till date, that is actually the gap, that is the bridge.
Because I have been detached with class 12 since last 1 year, sir. I was preparing for some competitive examination. Therefore, I wasn't able to focus on these chapters. So I have forgotten many things and I have to revise again, sir.
Yes. Actually, this is the problem with every student. The student who has passed in March, who has given exams in March, actually, physics exam was already done, I hope, in that period. So, all those students are facing that problem. So, there is no issue about it, because whatever the topic we will be having, we will have the discussion about your means where you connect with your 10 plus 2. Okay. It is not like that we will be starting a new and a fresh topic will be there without any discussion. Like today I have discussed interference, right? But interference, yes, you know that what is there in 10 plus 2, how interference diffraction is there. Okay. So yes, today's class was just to give you can say an idea that okay, we'll have this kind of interference classes. But we cannot complete interference class in one class. Okay.
Yes,
so we will be having regular classes when the class routine will be starting from Friday. So you will see that in a very small pattern and small topics we will discuss in every class, and it will be very easy to understand for you people.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so please join all of you at 9:30 on Friday, right?
And another thing, sir. Another
yes.
Doubt?
Okay, sir. Yes.
Sir, since we are not able to access the library, so how will we manage the book? Because we have to go through the book.
Just a second. For that purpose, we have created our virtual laboratory, and I will provide you the link for that PDF. One PDF is there. If you click on that topic, the book for that particular topic will be open. Okay.
Sir, but for that virtual laboratory, we need to have laptops. But many.
No, in your mobile also that will open. Virtual laboratory is there. Virtual laboratory, for that virtual laboratory, you need one laptop. But for virtual library, he is asking for library. So,
yes,
for library, the book will open in your mobile also. There is no issue. You can download and save it.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you then. Thanks a lot. So we'll see you on Friday, right? 9:30.
Okay, sir.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye,
sir.
Okay, sir. Bye.